In this video, I am going to explain anatomical relationship around neck and face. This relationship is very important for neck movement, jaw mechanics, and maybe for head mechanics. I am going to explain kind of four places today. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Throat, mouth, jaw, and cervical spines. Let me explain around throat first. Okay, what is there around throat? There are esophagus and trachea and thyroid. These are like digestive system and endocrine system and circulatory system, right? So you can see throat as internal organ area. And if you look carefully, there are muscles around throat. And in front of cervical spines, there is muscle as well. So if esophagus gets disease, or maybe trachea and thyroid got dysfunction, maybe this dysfunction can affect these muscles. Okay? And what happens when these muscles get tight? Maybe cervical spines get tight. Why? Because there's muscle in front of cervical spines. So when anterior part gets tight, that may affect movement of cervical spines. If people think about tight neck, they most likely think about posterior part muscles. Of course, these muscles are so important, but as equally, front part is important because there are internal organs plus few muscles. That is why tight throat area can affect cervical spines area. That's simple, right? This is like a front and back relationship. Now, let me explain area around mouth and tongue. Okay, what is there? What is around mouth? There is facial expression muscle. There is lips. There is tongue inside of mouth. And there are muscles beneath mandible. You don't see these muscles, so let me change pictures. Then you can see more clear relationship. So this is inferior view. This is mandible. This is thyroid, anterior part of neck. What I was talking about is these muscles. These muscles are sometimes called floor of mouth. It's literally bottom of mouth. That is why this area is floor of mouth. This area is connected to throat area and tongue. So what happens when this area gets tight? Maybe anterior part of neck gets tight. Or maybe movement of tongue gets tight. Again, this area is connected to tongue. Tightness around this area can affect movement of tongue. What happens when movement of tongue is inhibited? Maybe that can create speech problem. Maybe that can create swallowing problem because tongue is important for speech and what? Swallowing, right? That is why this area, floor of mouth, is important. Now let's go back to first picture. Okay, you saw floor of mouth. That's here. I said floor of mouth is connected to tongue, right? Now, what happens when tongue gets tight? Maybe floor of mouth gets tight. If you follow connection, maybe throat gets tight. When this area gets tight, maybe cervical spine is restricted. Do you see this relationship? this anterior part of neck and face is kind of minor place if you think about neck movement. But if you see this relationship, now you may have new idea that when you have to treat tight cervical area, maybe you need to check tension of tongue, tension of mandible, tension of throat area. This area is equally important as posterior part. I explained relationship between throat, number one. Number two, face and tongue and flow of mouth, two. Now let me explain jaw area. Okay, this is jaw. This joint is freaking important for opening up mouth and closing mouth. That is why you have these muscles. This is one of the chewing muscle. This is mastication muscle. Mastication means chewing. There are several mastication muscles around face and head. When these muscles get tight, that can affect this joint. This is temporal mandibular joint. Temporal mandibular joint. And if flow of mouth or tongue gets tight, that can affect temporal mandibular joint. Why? Because there are few muscles that attaches to mandible. Then there is a bone called hyoid bone. Hyoid bone. Then it goes to around temporal bone. Why is temporal bone so important? Because temporal bone organizes this temporal mandibular joint, which is jaw. That is why tension around floor of mouth and tongue can affect temporal mandibular joint. You see this relationship? Again, tongue and floor of mouth, that can affect jaw. Now let's add one more thing. Throat. Okay? When this area gets tight, that may affect this joint. Do you see this relationship? Now tightness around this area can affect cervical spines. Of course, tight cervical spines can affect each of place. Maybe tightness for mouth, tightness for throat, tightness for temporal mandibular joint. This relationship is very, very minor if you consider about cervical spine tightness, but I have to keep repeating. Tightness around anterior part is very important. Now, let me add one more thing. What is it? That is facial muscle. Why do I focus on facial muscles? These muscles are not for joint movement. That's for movement of face. Why is that so important? Okay, let me give you one more example. This muscle. This muscle is orbicularis oris. Okay. Orbicularis oris. It's like a circular muscle around lips. This muscle is important for speech and chewing and maybe for swallowing, right? Because this is entrance of food. So maybe you can say this area is connected to tongue. You know, lips and tongue need to move simultaneously when you speak, when you eat food, right? So maybe when this area gets tight, that can affect tongue, that can affect flow of mouth, then throat area. I know, facial muscle is very, very complicated and it's so deep. If you think about facial muscle, maybe you need to think about facial nerve. Facial nerve, that is cranial nerve 7. And plus, mastication muscle is innervated by trigeminal nerve. That is cranial nerve 5. So when you think about mouth, face, jaw, throat, maybe you need to think about cranial nerve. Throat area is innervated by glossopharyngeal, vagus nerve, cranial nerve number 9 and 10. If you think about tongue, this area, tongue is innervated by cranial nerve 12, hypoglossal. Again, if you think about face, neck, and throat area, maybe it's good to think about cranial nerve. I know this is very complicated, but I think this area is very, very interesting. So in this video, I explained relationship of throat, tongue, jaw, face, and cervical spine. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.